Hello, hello, everybody. It is 12:19 p.m. Central Time on the 19th of April, 2018. It's Thursday going into Friday. I hope you're doing well. And we're here on Earthquake 3D Livestream to talk about seismic events that have struck since last night. And we're looking currently at the last 48 hours worth of earthquakes from the USGS EMSC GeoNet down in New Zealand, giving us a good picture of what's happening. So since my update last night, what's happened? Japan and across the Aleutian Island chain going up into Alaska. A series of fours going to 4.9. That's right, 4.9 again. This one right on the coast of Honshu, northern Japan, 4.9. Then going across the Kuril Islands, 4.6. Then 4.5 and 4.0 and 4.1 in the central Aleutian Island chain. Then a new 4.5 right next to Mount Boguslav. You may remember me talking about that in last night's update. Today it got hit right in the middle fulcrum point. Notice the equal distance spacing of these 4.0 earthquakes spreading out from the West Pacific going across over into Alaska over the past couple days. I mean, come on, look at it. Coming out of Japan, boom, 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 and boom. Going right across, ending at the Canada border with Alaska. Getting over into the West Pacific, look, we have a new deep earthquake popping up here at 414 kilometers deep. If we consult our depth to magnitude conversion chart, looking at about 415, we add on 0.8 magnitude to this earthquake. So you add on 0.8 and it gets up into, well, let's just put it at near 5.1 as our total magnitude that could be resulting from this deep quake. Where's it going to strike? In the silent zone, and this one in between our two sets of quakes, over to the west, most likely, east of Papua New Guinea, west of Vanuatu. Down in New Zealand itself, we go all the way south, right down onto our dutchsinse logo, where we have a new 4.6 that struck. And that's a somewhat regular occurrence. You see where our arrow points down to the X? We see activity break out from here across the X over to the other X's as a result of pressure transferring down to the south coming from our deep earthquakes in New Zealand itself. Yesterday, deep activity on the northern island of New Zealand, deep 3, I think it was a deep 3.2 at 262 kilometers deep. That, again, let me go ahead and turn on a display capture here so you can see my mouse now. That deep earthquake resulting today with shallower activity, and it's picking up in pace, the number of earthquakes increasing down in New Zealand, compared to where we were yesterday at least. Over in the West Pacific, fulcrum point hit again, and it's right between our 4.2 and 4.3. This is Mount Sinabung right here. We told you guys when Mount Sinabung or any volcano erupts, we get near 5.0 earthquake activity striking next to each volcano, and that's what's happened again today. Now look at this, Iran. Iran got hit. We told you on the Sunday night forecast, Iran was going to be getting smacked around. And this is at the halfway point between the two spots that we warned. We warned right here at the Iran-Iraq border, and we warned right here at the southern portion of the plate boundary. And right in between, we got a 5.8 to 6.0 earthquake and a 5.5 subsequent. But this actually went up to 6.1 detected by some agencies. USGS has it at 5.8. So we told you on Sunday night, they were getting smacked around. Why was Iran getting smacked around? The fives that were coming out of China that the USGS and all the other agencies, if you use any of those sites, they didn't give you those earthquakes out of China. You had to go to the Chinese agency to get the information. And so five struck in China, and now we get a 5-point cumulative total. It all adds up, and we get a 5.9 to 6.0 earthquake striking here in South Iran. This means over to the west, Europe is going to see an increase, and while it already has started to see an increase since the 5.9 struck last night, you look across today, look who got hit. Here, let me show you the larger activity. Let me go ahead and name it for you. Albania got hit, Crete got hit, and South Italy got hit. Albania and South Italy, same-sized earthquake, 3.3, 3.4. Did we issue a warning for Albania? Sure did. Bosnia-Albania border, we issued the warning at the arrow, and we told you whatever was coming out of Crete would go up into the west and split between Bosnia, Albania, and Italy. Well, there it is. Same-sized earthquakes coming out of 3.9. Take a few points down. 3.4 and 3.3 spreading out to the west-northwest. And then we go into the twos from there. So spreading from our threes, then we take another step down, going to twos, and then another step down, going to ones as we spread across the plate. Last night's earthquake, we talked about this last night, the 5.5 striking right next to our letter X. This 5.5, we know where it came from all the way over here when a 5.5, now downgraded to 5.4, struck off the coast of Colombia. First this one struck, then this one struck. And that's why we got a big arrow there. It's been on there for years, and we watch for the pressure to transfer across. As we get into South America, look where our big arrow points here. Right in here to South Chile, Central Chile. Nevados del Chilean volcano finally showing back up on the feeds after a couple weeks, if not more, several weeks without showing any activity. Now Nevados del Chilean right here at the backside of our arrow. See where it says travels underneath? Look where we get our other earthquakes. The cumulative total of everything that strikes here transfers down, around, and underneath, goes underneath the plate, comes back up at the South Sandwich Islands. And all you have to do is add together the earthquakes that strike here over a course of a few days, add them together literally just magnitude-wise, adding point by point, and that leads you to 5.something, 5.2 to 5.3, and that's what we got down here, 5.0 to 5.2. Central America going into Mexico. I had somebody write me and say, you know, Mexico's not Central America. It's part of North America. Look, I mean, if I could care about those little details, it does not matter to me. Mexico's Central America. This is Central America. This landmass that starts here and goes up to here, that's called Central America. Now, you can split hairs on North America, NAFTA, and so forth. Mexico being part of America as opposed to Central America, whatever. You know what I'm talking about. It's the landmass south of North America and north of South America. And we call that landmass Central America. And whether or not you want to split hairs on whether or not it's Mexico or not is nitpicking, in my opinion. So here we are. We're looking at Central America, and we're going into Guatemala, going down to Costa Rica. And next to our volcano in Costa Rica, that's Turrialba volcano right there. New activity going up into the 3 range. That's not that big. But there's our 5.4. We were looking for a mid-range 5. I said watch up for up to a 5.5 striking off the coast of, we said watch between Galapagos and Colombia, right? Here's the Galapagos right here, and here's Colombia right here. Well, we're halfway between Galapagos and Colombia, and we get our mid-range 5. Up to the north, though, in South Mexico, we're going up into the upper 4s. If you take the 4.8 plus the 4.3 plus the 4.7 plus the 4.1, we're already to 5.0. Colima volcano just got hit with new 4.0 activity today. This was our halfway fulcrum point. Each halfway fulcrum point is being hit, equidistantly spaced. Look, this isn't me doing anything. We can turn off the rings. This is the location of each swarm, equidistantly spaced across Mexico and Central America. As we get into the United States, let's talk about this. Look what happened today. A new 3.8. And 3.2 and 3.3, but I'm particularly concerned about the 3.8 and 3.2, striking at the Oklahoma-Kansas border panhandle region. Let me turn down the ring so you can see here. So here's the panhandle of Oklahoma, and right at the panhandle of Oklahoma, a 3.8 earthquake. Well, that fits perfectly with this week's forecast, save one thing. We haven't seen any earthquakes off the West Coast. This proves it to me. They're hiding earthquakes off the West Coast, guys. They are. It's sad. It's a sad state of affairs. Maybe there's some stupid order issued by somebody that's causing that. Well, whatever. We know for certain now there's activity happening off the West Coast, and then we're seeing activity strike in the Midwest. So you can pretty much bet there was a 4.0 earthquake off the West Coast yesterday. Now look at this. What are we at? We're at another pumping operation. These are drill points. We're doing wastewater injection, gas and oil extraction. And look at how many different points there are. Every single one of these is a different spot where humans have drilled in. Look at that. They even have the pipeline still laid out there. You got a truck there, too. All right. And it just goes on and on for miles. All of these little square pads are different spots. Again, wastewater injection has been proved to induce earthquake activity. Now, the earthquake activity is being caused ultimately by pressure. that's coming from the West Coast. So it's not like it's the oil company's fault. They got bad advice from their staff geologist, who said, and still as of this past week even, I had a staff geologist, a person who is involved in the industry, who claimed that that earthquakes are can't be caused by fracking or drilling of any kind. Well, you know, they're wrong. That's why we're having a problem right now. The professionals were in denial about pressure transferring across the plate. And now we know pressure is transferring across the plate, and that's why we get similar-sized earthquakes in the course of a few days' time. I mean, come on. Look, how many times do I have to say this? But I'm going to say it one more time. Do you see our 3.8? Why did a 3.8 strike in Oklahoma? Of all the numbers to strike in Oklahoma today, seriously, like, it could have been a 3.9, could have been a 3.5, could have been a 5.0. Why is it a 3.8? Well, we go back a day and a half. You also remember this if you're a viewer of mine. We had a swarm of three, a cluster of 3.8s break out across the West Coast. 3.8 up in Montana, 3.8 over here near San Francisco, 3.8 down in Southern California, and a 3.8, which they downgraded to 3.7 at Coso Junction. So 3.8, 3.8, 3.8, 3.8, all in the past few days over on the West Coast. Now a 3.8 striking at the pumping operations in the Midwest. They're related. It's not an accident, chance, happenstance, or coincidence. It's definitely related. There was a 3.8's worth of pressure put across the entire western portion of North America in the course of a day or two's time. Now, where did it come from? Well, we have a big silent zone out here where they're refusing to report earthquakes, and we have a cluster of fours near fives coming out of Alaska. So it's built up here, pushed across the edge of the plate, and gone down into the Midwest. And that's why we got a new 3.8 right in our warned area. You remember, I issued the warning for the panhandle of Oklahoma this week and said it was going to be going up in the 4 range. Why? And it could even go larger. We're waiting for an earthquake to strike up here in the Northwest that could be 5.0. But already we're there. We are here. Now, there's a spot in between here in Nebraska where there's a series of threes that are breaking out at a 5-kilometer depth. Now, something interesting was said to me just the other day. As somebody from the industry took issue with what I was saying, and they were trying to correct me publicly, they mentioned that they were part of the drilling operations in Oklahoma for the last several years, and that they drilled to a 25,000-foot depth. 5 miles. That's for somebody in the industry who's trying to debunk me and trying to say that I was wrong on something. They admitted that they've drilled down to 5 miles. Now, that completely flies in the face of what we were told about Oklahoma, Kansas, and the depths that they are drilling. If they're drilling to 5 miles, 25,000 feet, I'm going to have to say, don't you think that that could lead to earthquake activity if you have a shaft that's that large with that much fluid in it and that charged with gas and fluids, that it's going to, again, cause earthquake activity? So we're zooming in here, and I don't see any nearby pumps or wells. Why is that? Over the past couple of years, there was a debate that started to be held here in the, well, not just in this county, but in the state of Nebraska, as to whether or not they were going to allow new exploratory drilling to see for oil and gas across Nebraska. And then there was a further debate about wastewater injection. Now, I'm going to show this to you because I think it's important. We're going to go Nebraska, wastewater injection debate. See if the videos still come up. Well, look, here's my videos from 2015. Wow, that's pretty interesting. I'm not seeing any of the videos come up, guys. You know, that's troubling because there was a big debate and all kinds of video shot at the local level. And look at what they got going on here. Not coming up at all. Well, let's go over and look on YouTube. Nebraska wastewater debate. Oh, there it is. Oh, what do you know? You go search it on good old Google and they censor it. And look, it's got 2.2 million views. This thing right here, even Young Turks covering it. You gotta be kidding me. Well, funny how they got that censored. Yep, 2015. Nebraska Oil and Gas Conservation Commission hearing on out-of-state company's application to export its toxic fracking wastewater into Nebraska, moving 80 truckloads carrying 10,000 barrels per day of pollution destined to be dumped into a disposal well in Sioux County. Sioux County. Where's Sioux County? Let's go find that out. Sioux County, Nebraska. Okay. Oh, okay. We're going across the sand dunes. There's Sioux County. So fracking here on the western part of the state in 2015. Now, do you think they might open it up to others? It's a question you got to ask. I don't have the imagery to show you. I just have to tell you. They're doing exploratory drilling, wastewater injection, and we know, and look at the depth. Look at the depth on these earthquakes. 5 km. What more can I say? Just like all the others. You go around, you look, 5 km here. And you go here, look, 5 km. Okay, 3.5 km, refined. Reviewed, they all start at 5 km. So all happening at 5 km, all happening near drill points, and all of these other spots, every single other spot down to the south, outside of Nebraska, at a pumping operation. That's not an exaggeration. That's Kansas, Oklahoma. You guys can fact check me on that if you need to. Go pull each coordinate and look it up. Even this 2.8 down in Texas. Look at that, 5 km depth. Gee, oh yeah, I guess all the earthquakes are just at 5 km all of a sudden, huh? Just a chance of coincidence. It's just a coincidence that there's drill points there too, you know? Here, let's go look this one up. So here we are, we're again in Texas. Now, I've already shown this so many times, we have tens of thousands of drill points, and that's no exaggeration. We'll start here, going out here into the backcountry, but I mean, they become really visible. Do you see these? Maybe I should zoom in a little bit more. You see these? See what we got going on here? Drilling. Now, of course, Texas is known for its drill points. Texas is known for its pumping operations. Now, this is actually sparsely spaced. Sparsely, yes. Look at what's actually going on here. Look how many they've got. I mean, we're talking oil fields comparable to Saudi Arabia. And that's just one little patch here going over to the east. The entire counties are completely drilled. Every single pad. So that's why a 2.8 earthquake is striking there. From this high, it almost just looks like little grids of some kind. But then you zoom in and you start seeing how they've really just gone insanely over and above and, you know, anything that we would call excessive. It's beyond that. So pressure releases at drill points. Nobody should be shocked by that. Now let's go over to the West Coast, take a quick look at the 0.0 and greater earthquake feed since last night. This is all I'm really concerned about, the last 12 hours since my update last night. Okay, so the last 12 hours, what do we got going on? Northern California up at Geysers still swarming. Southern California still swarming down at Anza Gap, and we still have two stacks of quakes. We're back into the LA Basin with a 1.7, and the creeping section of the San Andreas going into the South Hayward is moving. The 2.0 from yesterday at Colinga, still on the map. That's a pumping operation, oil and gas. We showed that in last night's update. Mammoth Mountain, Whitmore Hot Springs is also moving. But Nevada, look at Nevada. Hardly anything in Nevada. Hardly anything up to the north either. Just a few zeros and ones. I think that's going to be changing in the next few days. Over the course of the next couple days, I'm looking for some activity to develop off the West Coast. Now, are they going to report it? Probably not. It doesn't matter if they do or don't. Now, look at the last 48 hours. Look at this. First of all, look at the last 24 hours. Do you see these hundreds of little red dots? These just appeared since last night. So 48 hours, we had a little cluster up to the north in between Victoria and Seattle at the Strait of Juan de Fuca. But now, down to the south, look at this cluster, man. I mean, it has broken out. So we're at Medford, Oregon, north of Medford. I think that's a place, Roseburg? Hold on, let's go find the name of it. Here's Medford, here's Grants Pass. Yeah, Roseburg. In between Grants Pass and Roseburg, we have ourselves a slow slip that's taking place. The plate is in motion at this location. Up to the north, it's pretty much stopped in the last 24 hours. 48 hours ago, it was moving. So this spot in Oregon, we got to look out to sea. If it's happening between Roseburg and Grants Pass, let's just find the halfway point between Roseburg and Grants Pass. Then let's just approximate right here. Okay? So now I'm going to back it out. We need to look off the coast and see what's out there. What's to the west of this? Do you see anything? Going due west, where does it take us? It takes us into the triangular pinnacle point of the Juan de Fuca. But technically, this is the Gorda Ridge going into the cleft segment, but This is the Juan de Fuca fracture zone overall, going all the way up. And this is the southern arm of it, where we have a triangular point. It's like it's an arrow pointing into the spot that's moving. And the spot that's moving on land is corresponding to something that's going on out to sea. So what's going on out in the sea? They can detect these little vibrations. They can show small tremors out there. There aren't any earthquakes being reported. Anything beyond the, right along the shoreline. There's nothing being shown out to sea. But that's very, very strange. There should be earthquakes being reported out here over the course of weeks and months. There should be a few fours and fives striking every week out here. And the fact that they're not reporting them to us, when we've got reports of a rising mountain and other things that are happening out there, and we're seeing California and the Midwest get hit, but there's a missing link in between the two? Come on. I mean, we don't even need them to show them to us. We know what's good. We can fill in the blank. So I'm waiting for a five to pop up here. Are they going to show it to us? I don't know. Like I said, it doesn't matter. It's not out. It's out in the ocean anyways. All it does is aid me in my forecasting. It's not. Nobody's going to feel a five out in the ocean out off the coast of Vancouver Island. Or if they do, it'll be very small. So that is the update for right now. One more time. Iran. Salam. Word up and much love. Guys, we told you to watch for it. And we told you why. If you want to hear the warning for Iran specifically, it's in my global earthquake forecast video over on my YouTube channel. And it's right here. Issued on the 15th. And you can come forward. I don't even know how far in the video we're going to go. But coming forward into the video right about... Let me show it here. There we go. I'll just go ahead and play it. You guys can hear it for yourself. So just listen. This is my Sunday night forecast for the Mideast entire region. We also need to warn the people in Iran. Southern central Iran, centered in between our two arrows. We're going to look here for a 5.9 to 6.0 earthquake. Again, another 5.9 to 6. How am I coming to that conclusion? There's been several earthquakes back behind you over the past several days. Take the 4.9 plus the 4.1 plus the 4.2 plus the 4.1 plus the 4.7 plus the fives that were striking in China that USGS and everybody else is now not reporting again. We're back to that in case you didn't know. So there's been unreported fives over in China this week. Well, that adds up. Even though they don't report them, it's the tree in the woods thing. Yeah, does it make a sound? Well, you know, what it depends on what your definition of a sound is. Let's play some Clinton on this. You know, it depends on what your definition of is. Well, here we are. We're back over and it's going to hit. And it's a result of the pressure coming out of China that they just don't want to tell us about. There you go. 5.9 to 6.0 is what we issued the forecast for. We got a 5.8, 5.5. And you add the 5.8, 5.5. It actually came out to 6.0 according to the Europeans. And according to the Russians and everybody else, the USGS came in at 5.8. Whatever. That's the earthquake we were looking for, and it had been quiet the previous week, only a few smaller events. So the reason that Iran got smacked around this week is because China sent a seismic pressure blast over your way. And why did China do that? Well, it's not their fault. It's from the West Pacific, displacing the entire portion of the West Pacific with deep earthquakes. Our deep earthquakes are raised high off the globe, and then they push outwards and away, then displacing Asia, then displacing the Middle East, then displacing Europe, then going out to the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. So when we issue our warnings, I take it very serious, and I'm trying to reach the people in Iran. I'm trying to reach the people around the world. I want everybody to have an earthquake plan. You know, there are no enemies of mine that I don't want to have an earthquake plan. We are not trying to, you know, get into this whole politics thing with everybody going around the world. I want everybody in each country to pay attention to the seismic activity and pay attention to it coming their way. So the people in Iran, you need to look to China and watch the activity coming out of China. And people in Europe, you need to look to Iran and Turkey and watch for the activity coming out of Iran and Turkey to be coming your way into South Mediterranean. And North Europe, you have to watch the South Mediterranean for the activity that's striking in Italy and Greece to come your way up to the Northwest. And people out at Iceland and Azores, you've got to watch South Europe and Central Europe for the total cumulative total of everything coming out of there to come your way and add up and finally strike at the termination point. I hope I've made myself...